You know, I don't even have to ask for everybody's attention. I know I've said this every time I get out here, and I've never said it to another student body of which I've been principal. You guys are the finest student body that I have ever been I've ever had the privilege of working with. I am also very, very glad that we have kindergartners, first graders. Let's give those young kids a hand. Okay, folks, you guys are in for a big treat, but we also have one of our board members here that is responsible for doing so many things and organizing so many wonderful things for us. I'm going to let her introduce what you're getting ready to see, and that is Ms. Kim Cobb.
Here. So today you're going to have a treat. You're going to see Carrie the Cure. Bill Pegorin has been to Galena several times to help with Rip and Hook, and he's come out with Broken Walls and with Carrie the Cure. And this is their sixth annual Iditarod Trail Tour. So as of this year, they've hit every village along the Iditarod Trail at least once in the last 6 years, just carrying a message encouraging youth to choose to commit to life. So you guys are going to have a lot of fun and just enjoy what they're doing. Thank you guys for coming.
Come on and ride away. Jonathan.
Yes, sir.
So, you know, Galena is my favorite place in the world to come, right?
That's
so,
what you say.
And Jonathan here, Jonathan, Mr. Mohawk, is like one of my best friends of all time. And he's Mohawk. But since you guys are so awesome, I'm thinking maybe you should adopt him as Mohawks really quick. Do you guys like to be Mohawks?
Yeah.
Honorary Mohawks.
Honorary Mohawks.
So at the end of every traditional song in our love house, when our people dance and we do our social gatherings, the lead singer, he'll be carrying his small drum and he'll be up in front. And all the people, he does call and response. So at the very end of the song, you heard what we just did. I went, what? So if you want to be honorary Mohawks with us, you always have to act like you're all the dancers behind the lead singer. So when I go whoop, you guys all go whoop. Alright, you ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, whoop! Oh, you guys can do better than that. I know it's early in the morning, but we need stronger Mohawks. We were a fierce warrior people. Whoop! Alright, that's not bad. Next song we're going to do is a song called Why We Dance. And then Bill is gonna make you honorary Clinkets. Yeah. Wanna be honorary Clinkets? Maybe you better be that right now. Okay, yeah, they are Alaskans, right? How many Alaskans do we have here? That's what I'm thinking. Mohawks, yeah, you guys are fierce warriors, but Clinkets, we are warriors too. And we Alaska natives, we are rough, tough, raw, and rugged people, right? So this is what we Clinkets do.
Alright.
We go, hoo! Right? So give me your strongest hoo on the count of three.
Come on, stand up to do it.
Oh yeah, you better stand up. Yeah, that's true. You can always support the sound better when you stand up.
There you go.
Alright. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Hoo! Oh come on, let's show them all.
Culture of the Lakota people.
And when they dance, in certain dances, each step, they say each step is for the healing of the land. And so we believe there's a lot of things that need healing in Alaska, don't we?
Yeah.
And so what we're believing for is each step be for the healing, to break off suicide, to break off family dysfunction, to break off alcoholism, and those kind of things. So when we dance this song, it's a sacred song. So as you tap your foot there, you're being a part of it with us to break those things that are hurting Alaska. This song's called Why We Dance.
Hand in hand.
Thank you.
back at Galena. I want to introduce the band to you. That was Paul Starling right there on the ground. Thank you, Paul. Over there from Peter's Creek. Peter's Creek, Alaska. That's Josh Moss on the bass. And then Mr. Mike Mohawk himself from Talladega, Ontario, Canada, the leader of Broken Walls. Some mighty dancers with us tonight. We have the awesome, the beautiful, the mighty Carol Sullivan. One of your very own Carol has traveled with us to Germany, to UK, all over the place. And right next to her is Casey Church. Albuquerque, and he ended up here in Galena. Yeah. No, it's a right turn, yeah? He's Potawatomi. And then we have some other friends. We have many friends on this team. Hey, right back there with Paul, that's Jonathan Lockery. That's good. Let's pick that up and I'll pay you. All right. And then right there behind him is my good friend, Marla Rowland. She grew up on the Yukon. Aviation pilots are the pilots. Are they around here anywhere? Where are our pilots? Oh, right over there. There's one. And most cool DJ Gaik from Wasilla. Or Bill, whichever one you'd like to use. You know, there were these three dogs, you know, these three male dogs, and this one beautiful collie dog. And this collie, she was beautiful. And these three male dogs, they wanted to take her out on a date, you know what I mean? So they were like, you know, there was a bulldog, there's a Doberman Pinscher, and a Chihuahua. Yeah, and all three of them wanted to go out on this date with this beautiful collie. So then, you know, she walked by them. She knew it. She just kind of walked by them and said, whichever one of you can use the words liver and cheese in the same sentence, that is the one I will go out with. So the bulldog, he muscled his way in there. And he goes, oh, I can handle this. He says, I love liver and cheese. And she's like, oh, that's so dumb. And then the Doberman Pinscher kind of butts in. And he says, oh, it's easy. I hate liver and cheese. And then, you know, she's going, oh, that was just as dumb as the other one. Just about the time, you know, just right after she got those words out of her mouth, the Chihuahua butts in. And she goes, and he goes, liver alone. Cheese mine. Yes. You know me. You know, I like those cheesy jokes, right? Ever? We have our elementary school guys. Hey guys, are you learning your ABCs? You learning your vowel sounds? Vowel sounds. What are your vowel sounds? A, E, I, O, and U. Sometimes. Sometimes what? Hey, yeah, you know, on my presentation, we learned our vowel sounds too. Yeah, this is how we learned it. E! I owe you, eh? Why? Alright, I told you I like cheesy jokes. Okay, anyway, I'm the drummer of Broken Walls. That's Jonathan America. We had traveled around the world. We played in large venues like Life Flight. We played in stadiums and like the Olympic Stadium and places like that. But you know, like I said earlier, nothing beats coming to the villages of Alaska. To me, that is way cooler than playing some big stadium. You know, but you know, I need to ask you, that's pretty cool, but how many of you have had bad days? Had bad days before? Good days! Yeah, I mean, you like good days better than bad days.
No bad days, right?
Yeah, well, I couldn't do this without my family and Ari and Rain, that's my wife and children. I've been married to the same woman for 24 years. She's amazing. You know, she's one of the reasons I am here today. And we made a promise to love each other in good times and bad, and we never used the D word. Divorce. Murder, yes. Divorce, never. Okay, anyway. Most of the time we have good days, but introduce the team to you. Now, right now, we're going to play a game, and I need some bodyguards for this one. Okay, DJ, can you help me out here? And Josh, can you stand right here in front of me here? Okay, I want to make this game really clear, okay? I'm going to ask you if you have something in your pocket, stand in front of me. You are my bodyguards, my shields, okay? All right, so, right on. Okay, so I'm going to ask you if you have something in your pocket, and then the first one to bring it up gets a prize, right? Right, Lexi? Where'd you go? Oh, yeah, right. That's cute. I thought I was going to be a mom or something like that. Now, I have to warn you, if you don't follow the rules, I have a special set of skills. And I will figure out who you are. I will find you. And I will... Well, I better stop there. Okay, a nickel. Someone bring me a nickel. Who has a nickel? Come on, bring it up here. A nickel. First one to give me a nickel, it's a prize. Nickel, come on now. We should have some music here. All right, here we got a nickel. All right. And a prize. All right. Next one, a credit card. A credit card. I will get it back, okay? Okay, right there. All right. I did that in Shaq-tulik. It's okay. Aren't you Shaq-tulik? Really? Hey, DJ, didn't I do that? Right, Paul? With Marla? I was just running and I went, bam! It's like, it's okay! Next one! I need pocket lint. Give me some pocket lint, someone. Somebody's got some pocket lint. Come on, bring it up. What? Your coat, your pocket, come on. Pocket lint. First one, here we go. Oh! I'll give them both something. Oh, it's Josh even. Pocket lint. We will save that for later. Alright. Now, okay, next thing. Gum. Any type of gum. Stick of gum. Gum. Oh, hey, man. Hey, you can put that there. Alright. There you go. You can have the facts back here. Hey, go, bro. Wait, let me have one of those first. Well, I'll take a stick of gum. Then you can go back to it. Makeup! Any type of makeup, chapstick, come on, makeup.
Come on, ladies. Please, makeup.
Oh, nice. Woo. Here we go. Hey, you can have it back. That's not my color. I'm a summer. Okay. A shoe. Bring it up. Don't keep up. Okay, here we go. Thank you so much. Give her a prize, thank you. Yeah, I was, you know, I have these guys here because the other person was popping. I said, give me a shoe. And the shoe went flying from me to the top of the teacher and went, boom. And I'm like, I'm kicking, I'm okay. But I'm starting to get hungry. I need you now. All right, so a brush or a comb. Comb or a brush?
Brush, comb, come on, somebody.
We need a little bit of music here, traveling music for the folks here. Uh-oh, we're in trouble. We have no combs or brush this year. Wait, right over here, someone's got it. You got a brush or a comb? Oh, wait, here we go. All right, here we go. Okay, a strand of hair. One strand, not a whole lock. Okay? Strand of hair, come on, bring it up. All right, now we got one right here. Photograph. Be your phone, okay?
Photo.
collection with all the chewed food and chewed gum that I've gotten on the tour. I think I can make like a big ball now. Just saying. Alright, guys. Thank you. Thanks for helping me with that pocket scavenger game. Yes. That you are special, that there's something that you were born to do that no one else can do. Now turn to the person next to you and say, I'm special. All right, I'm really. Guys are pretty special. But you know, we played that pocket scavenger game too, and I want to say this, that it's not important really what's in your pocket, right? But what's more important right now is what's in your heart. That's what's important. Not so much what's in your pocket. I tell you what, the money that you have in your pocket, the stuff in your pocket, can buy your way out of hurt, pain, and shame. Money can't solve your problems. Drugs can't solve your problems. Relationships can't solve your problems alone. Now we need people, we need help. But I'm saying it takes more than things, right? Okay, so as you're thinking about that, we're gonna do another commercial. How's that?
Yeah.
Lots of commercials.
Dismissed from drama school with a note that read, wasting her time, but she's too shy to put her best foot forward. Turned down by the Decca recording company who said, we don't like their sound and guitar music is on the way out. A failed soldier, farmer, and real estate agent, at 38 years old, he went to work for his father as a handyman. Cut from the high school basketball team, he went home, locked himself in his room, and cried. Might succeed by virtue of his pleasant personality. Fired from a newspaper because he lacked imagination and had no original ideas. His fiancée died. He failed in business twice. He had a nervous breakdown and he was defeated in 8 elections. If you've never failed, you've never lived.
So if you've never failed, you've never lived. All right, you know, how many of you, like the first time you rode a bike, you crashed? Yeah. Snow machine. Oh, no, okay. Four-wheeler. It's like, you know, but see, you know, we learn from our mistakes, right? And just like that commercial there, just like that video. If you've never failed, you've never lived. Life equals risk. Now, hey, I want to give a shout out and honor you basketball players. I know you guys fought hard and did a great job. Oh, boys and girls, put your hands together for the basketball players. You know what? You know, Michael Jordan, did you see the video? Michael Jordan, when he first tried out for the basketball team, failed. And then he went home and cried. But he didn't give up. He didn't give up. He learned from his mistakes. He practiced. He tried harder. He probably found people that could help him. Right, John?
That's right.
Yeah, found some good coaches or other good basketball players to hang around. And then he got better and better and better. And I think that Michael Jordan is one of the all-time greats. How many of you would say that? Michael Jordan, yeah. One of the greats, yeah. Well, see, you, like those other people, like, gosh, Thomas Edison, right? Man, if Thomas Edison gave up after he failed, you all would be in the dark. You know what I'm saying? We all have, like, little candles in here in the gym, you know? We wouldn't have the light bulb if it wasn't for him. Or your jams. Your jams on your iPhones and your iPads. Because he made the first way of reproducing music, the photograph, right? Thomas Edison. Do you guys know this?
No.
Yeah, I did.
What are you teaching?
No. Just kidding. Anyway, but the important thing is that we learn from our failures. And you know, I know that all of people on my team, they have learned from their failures, and I'm still learning from mine. I still fail. DJ, no, don't raise your hand. DJ's like perfect, man. He's really cool. Anyway, hey, I want to tell you something. You know, your life, you were meant to live life with passion. Now, what's your name, darling? Paige? Paige, okay. In, let's say, maybe, after you're my daughter, 20 years when you get married. Because I would be dressing you up in Long John's and overalls until, you know, I felt you were old enough. I'd be protecting you. But anyway, one of these days, there's going to be some guy that's going to win your heart, right? Now, if he is like,
I love you.
You'd be like, dude, leave. Yeah, it's over, right? Right, girls? If men, you know, are not treating you right, you know, it's done. Okay, Dave, and if you need someone that's going to honor you and treat you right, ladies. But what I'm saying is, you know, they have to have a love for you and a passion for you. Now, that's kind of like our life. We need to have passion for life because you were born to live. Yeah, you're born to live. So anyway, I'm just saying like this. Now, the Greeks said it like this. I like the way the Greeks said it. Now, the Greeks, when they didn't care. They didn't care if you were a man or a woman, if you were a teacher, a doctor, a lawyer, a musician. It didn't matter what you were. But they asked one question when you died. Did this man or did this woman live a life of passion? That's it, Eric. That's it. Passion. That's what they cared about. But I need to tell you the truth.
I cannot tell a lie.
I need to tell you the truth. Is everywhere I go, I see dead people. Oh, no, it's not like paranormal with a sixth sense, you know. It's like this, you know. I need 4 volunteers. Really quick, 4 volunteers. Yes, 1. I guess 2 right in the middle. Okay, yeah, come on, dude. Will you with the spiky hair? Come on down. And, yeah, come on. Oh, you can come too. Come on, we'll have 5. All right. Come on down. How's it going? All right. Good, good. Hey, this is what we're going to do.
Hurry.
Awesome. We are going to go on an elevator ride, okay? Yeah, elevator ride. Woo! Okay, so what is the tallest building you've ever ridden an elevator in? Anchorage. And how many floors? I don't know. How about you? Anchorage? 11 floors. Right on. All right, okay. We're getting somewhere. How about you? Yeah! What is that? How many floors?
102.
Don't know? Any guesses? Okay, how about you? Have you ever been on an elevator? Okay. Just check it. Oh, hey, I go to some villages and communities are like, what's an elevator? Oh, we're going to go. We're going to find out. We're going to go on a ride. Okay. So anyway, check this out. What do we do when we go on an elevator? We're going to go on the elevator. Ding. First we open the door and then we all pile in. Let's all pile in. Come on, guys. And then, of course, the next thing, what do we do next? No, we got in the elevator. What are we going to do? The doors are shutting. Oh, yeah. What floor are we going to? Yeah, so push the button. Yeah, push the button, man. 13. Okay. Now some buildings don't even have 13, right? Anyway. Yeah, really. So, Empire State Building doesn't have 13. Okay, been there. Okay, so anyway, you push the button, and this is what happens. And, you know, the doors close, you push the buttons, and then you go like this. And you look at the numbers, and you go, 1, 2, I'm so uncomfortable, 3, you dare not look to the left, Dare not look to the right, but you look straight up at the numbers.
Right? Yeah, it's crazy.
It's crazy. So one time, it was in New York, and I went on in this one building, 98 floors. And I am thinking, man, I am not going to be able to handle just looking at the numbers. The 98th floor, in a small, tight space with all these strangers, I'm not going to do it. So the door's shut, and this is what happens. 98 floors, and I have to go to the very top, and then as soon as the door's shut, I turn around and go, "Hey guys, my name's Bill." Everyone in the elevator takes a step back. I said, "No, it's okay, I'm not going to take your wallet. Your eyes get really big." We're going to be on this elevator together for a while. Let's say we sing a song. Yeah, so I'm like, I put my hands up in the air sometimes. Come on. I want to celebrate and live my life. Say it. Let's go. Okay, anyway, so I'm doing that, or, because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like a room with... So anyway, I'm singing, maybe this is more your speed. I'm singing, I get to the 98th floor, bang, the door's open, I get out, and then this young lady's coming behind me, following me, and I'm like, "Hey, are you going to the same meeting I am?" And she's like, "No, I just wanted to finish the song." Yes, again, for them. Yeah, I'm telling you that the life that's in you and I is meant to come out. It's meant to impact people in a positive way. Right, bro? Man, it's like, guys, you give your, whatever, you say hello to people sometimes, and just a smile can make a difference in someone's life. Right? Right? Okay. Anyway, here's some things you can do. No way. Really? Okay, we're going to skip that. I'll go to the last one. Some things you can do on the elevator. You can call the psychic hotline and ask them to tell you what floor you're on. You can drop a pin, wait for them to pick it up, and then yell, "Stop! That's mine!" You could bring a camera on the elevator, take a picture, and say, "Come on." You could roll your desk onto the elevator and ask if they have an appointment when they get on the elevator. Or Thomas. Yeah, we could lay a twister mat down on the elevator floor, right? Ask if they want to play a game. So guys, it's important that life that's in you, though, really comes out and makes a difference, around you. And we only have a couple minutes here. I kind of got excited and lost track of time. I'm sorry, But I want to say something. I want to end with two things. This is one. What is this? $20. Who wants it? Alright, so, how about now?
I
still want it. How about now?
Yes!
How about this? You're not a $20 bill, you're a $1 bill.
I still want it.
Guys, check this out. We need to tell you, we came and we've been doing this Iditarod outreach because we want each and every one of you to know that you're not a mistake, that you're not a loser, you're not an accident, but you were born to do something that no one else can do. See, in my life was messed up when I was young and I almost gave up. I felt worthless. When I was 4 years old, my uncles used to have me take a hit off the marijuana joint. They would bet whether I could take shots of tequila and finish it. My parents divorced when I was 7. When I was 8 years old, I was already addicted to marijuana. And my own mother, she was like my dealer, my supplier. My home was so messed up from morning to tonight. I saw my sisters being hurt and abused and being misused. My mother, same thing, in and out of relationships and hurt and stuff like that. When I was 12 years old, my own mother gave full custody of me to a complete stranger who abused me in about every way you could think of. Physically, sexually, mentally, verbally. Man, it's like so impressive stuff in my life. And I felt worthless. I didn't feel valuable. I felt like ending it all. But there were little things that people did that kept me hanging on to life. You know, there were like smiles in the hallway, or sometimes it was just like, hey, yo, Bill, what's up? And that kept hanging on to life. This one time I had an elder in the community, and she goes like this, she goes, I hate the drugs. And she had this really mean look, and said, whoa, she hates the drugs. She must hate me. Then she got a smile, and she goes, but I love the way that you play the drums. Those are little things that kept me hanging on to life. There are many little things that got me to where I'm at today. And, you know, I don't feel worthless because of the people that helped me. Whether they were teachers, whether they were groups like Young Life, pastors in the community, elders. I stand before you as a crazy, happy Clinkapino. I'm Filipino and Clinkin. And Clinkapino, and I stand before you free from drugs and alcohol, free from the pain and hurt that other people inflicted on me. Free from the stupid stuff people did to me and the stupid stuff I did to myself. And so, you know, you may have gone through some tough times, and your family may have suffered some of the things I did, or some of our other team members, you know. But I want to tell you something, is that just like this $20 bill, when I straighten it out, you see that it's still worth the same as when I started. And that's like each and every one of you, that it doesn't matter what has happened in your life, whether you've been hurt or abused, misused, whether you've been told that you were an accident or a mistake or a loser, that is not the truth. The truth is that you have great value. You ladies are precious and beautiful. And we, our team, and I know others see that beauty and value in you. Guys, you're handsome, strong warriors, and you are meant to lead your families in ways that maybe your family didn't experience. I have a great family. I said I've been married 24 years, I have 3 children. I tell my son, he's 15 years old, he's taller than me now. Rain, many of you have met him. I tell him I love him. I give him hugs, you know, of course not in public. No, I'm not ashamed of that, neither is he. But anyway, you know, he is valuable, and he is going to lead his families in healthy ways. He doesn't have to have my story. You don't have to have a negative story that you experienced or maybe your family experienced, because you are valuable. You are precious. Each and every one of you. And so, as we end here, there's one thing we want to do. I can have 2 minutes. And that is, I want to talk to you about a vow. What is a vow? It's a promise. But it's not just any promise, but it's a promise that you never, ever break. Now, there are some promises that are worth keeping. But I know one promise that is not worth keeping. If you make a promise, if you know someone that says, hey man, I'm going to check out of life, I'm going to take my own life, I'm going to commit suicide, don't tell anyone. See, good friends don't keep deadly secrets. There's one of the exceptions there. Because if you love someone and they're your, you know, BFF, if they're your friend or whatever, you're going to want to see them commit to life. I promise you that if you commit to life, you'll have good days. You'll still have challenges. You'll still have bad days. But you will become better by learning how to work through those things. But a vow is a promise that you never, ever break. And you want to keep that promise. There are certain ones, you know. I like to remake The Three Musketeers because I think we've all read or seen movies about The Three Musketeers. Those dudes, they made a promise, right, to each other. I got your back, no matter what. And they said, all for one and one for all. So what I'm going to ask you to do is I'm going to show this video. And this is a vow to commit to life. If you guys want to see an end to depression and suicide in your villages, how many of you'd like to see that? You're tired of seeing your friends and families hurt. And the things that contribute to that, the drugs and alcohol, those things, you know, contribute to depression and could lead to suicide. But if you commit to life, no matter how tough things get, you can make a change and you can inspire others. We were inspired, right, Marla? When we went to Shagla, there's a young man, Justin Arrow, some of you know him. And so we got a chance to hang out with him quite a bit, and we did a song called The Healing Song, The Healing Dance. And, you know, he's been through some tough stuff, but he came out with us. First one, right before his whole village, and he danced the dance of healing. With broken walls. And the whole village was encouraged and inspired. That's the potential that you have in you. But you need to commit to life. Here's a video about committing to life. Teacher, doesn't matter, or stand right where you're at. But what we're going to do right now is that we're going to stand, and we're going to say this out loud and loud together. Okay, so everyone stand up. So, what we're going to do, awesome, thank you guys. So we're going to make this declaration. I will say this, I'm going to put it on the screen back here. You can read with me. And then I'm gonna say it, and then you're gonna repeat it, okay? You ready? You ready? All right, okay, here we go. I vow to commit to life.
I vow to commit to life.
And pursue my purpose.
And pursue my purpose.
Whether times are good or bad.
Whether times are good or bad.
Whether I have money or not.
Whether I have money or not.
when I'm sick.
Even when I'm sick.
When I'm alone or lonely.
I choose life.
When there's too much pressure.
Or when I've lost hope.
I'll ask for help.
I am valuable.
I am loved.
There is a good plan for my life.
I have a purpose. Come on, help me out, Annie. I commit to life. Come on, guys. Do it again. Let's do it.
I commit to life.
More. Come on.
I commit to life.
One more time.
I commit to life.
Awesome. You know what we're going to do? Hey, give yourselves a hand. That's awesome. Now, remember this. That is a promise. You just made a promise before everyone here. So I'll be watching you. And your friends will be watching you, right? Your enemies will be watching you. Commit to life. Make your life shine before others. Just do your best. No one's perfect. And did you see me drop a stick at the beginning of the show?
Yeah.
Yeah, you see that? All right, that was a total letdown, wasn't it? I don't care. It's okay. I just picked up my stick. I had more sticks. And I just kept playing, right? You know, that's what happens when we make a mistake in life. You know, we get up and then we keep going forward. We're going to do that same song right now as we close. We're going to do the healing song. And we're just going to ask you, just like Justin, we're going to ask you to just join us down here and to dance your prayers. You know, this is called the healing song. And Jonathan and I have been adopted as Lakota because of our travels. And one thing that they taught us is that when they dance, now they're good dancers. I mean, we have good dancers here in Alaska, but they dance a different style. But when they dance, every step that they take is like a prayer for healing. Healing for their land, for their people. On the count of three, I want you to shout out your village, okay? Wherever you're from, okay? Here we go. One, two, three. Okay, so come down here, and with this song, I want you all to just, and you don't have to dance like, you know, Carol or Casey, you know, you don't have to dance like me, but if you just, like, take steps like this. Now, today, there's a one-time only special offer that you can tap your toe inside your shoe. See that?
Look at that.
Right there. And we'll count that as a dance. But you just shouted out your village. You shouted out your community. And what it's going to take for each of us is getting up off our bottoms and doing something about the promises we made, right? It's one thing to say words, but it's another thing to walk it out, okay? Everyone, let's just walk this way. Walk, yeah.
Thank you.
at the eagle, and our elders used to teach us, they say, watch the eagle, and you need to be like him. They say, why? They say, because when the great storm comes, everybody runs and hides in their homes, the animals hide in their dens, and the birds go and hide, but the eagle, he flies right into the center of the storm. And the winds that you would expect would dash into the ground, when he puts out his wings, is what comes under his wings, and then he goes way up above the storm, and he's able to soar. It's one of his favorite times. He rides above the storm, and you need to be just like the eagle. You need to challenge the things that you have to take on in life, at school, whatever it is that you deal with. Don't run away from it. Deal with it like the eagle, and ride above, and gain those experiences that are going to take you through life. We're going to finish the song with a song called Fly.
Thank you.
actors to stand.